IC1020FR autoreader for Terragene Rapid, Super Rapid, Ultra Rapid Biological Indicators and Protein Pen Hygiene Monitoring System. With 12 positions for biological indicators and one position for protein pen readouts. A quick user guide. Turn on your IC1020FR by connecting it to a power source. The last incubation program will be selected by default. For biological indicators readout, hold the thermometer button to set the temperature. Use the same button to choose the right temperature for the corresponding readout program and wait for the autoreader to reach it. You can use the external thermometer to verify the temperature. When the IC1020FR reaches the selected temperature, the autoreader will perform the position's autotest. Green lights indicate the positions are ready to use. If a red light appears, this means there is an issue with that position. It will be automatically blocked, and you can normally use the remaining positions. Please get in contact with us so we can help you solve whatever the issue with that position may be. At this point, the thermometer button light will stop blinking and remain on. The IC1020FR allows you to choose two independent readout programs for biological indicators at the same time. One program for positions 1 to 6 and another for positions 7 to 12. These simultaneous programs must require the same temperature. Now, press the button to set the corresponding readout program. Press down the biological indicators cap. Break the ampole using an ampole crusher. Shake the biological indicator vigorously in order to ensure the culture medium gets in contact with the spore carrier. Now, place the biological indicator in any of the six positions where you previously set the corresponding readout program. Close the lid and wait for the result. Once the reading is in progress, if you take out a biological indicator from the position, an alarm will be triggered. If you put the biological indicator back in the position within 10 seconds, the reading will continue. If you don't, the alarm will stop after 10 seconds and the autoreader will print a cancellation ticket. When the readout process is done, the IC1020FR will print the results and display a red or green light. The green light means that the sterilization process was successful, while the red light indicates that the sterilization process failed. Further details will be shown in the print ticket. For Pro-1 protein pen readout, the temperature must be set at 60 degrees Celsius. Remember that the Pro-1 pen must be stored vertically and refrigerated. Before swabbing, it's important to remove the Pro-1 from the pouch and allow it to reach a temperature of 20 to 25 degrees Celsius. Now, remove the swab from the device and carefully apply 2 drops of moisturizer on the swab tip. Swab thoroughly the instrument's surface, pressing the swab and rotating it several times while collecting the sample. Place the swab back in the device and activate it by pressing it firmly downwards. Shake vigorously downwards for about 15 seconds until the solution turns green. Slide the swab upwards and shake the device again to ensure that all the liquid falls into the cup. After activation, the Pro-1 must be incubated immediately. Hold the Pro button to enable the reading mode. Place the protein pen in the corresponding position. Hold the Pro button for 1 second again to start the incubation and wait for the result. The Pro-1 reading process takes 7 minutes in IC1020FR and IC1020FR LCD incubators and 4 minutes in the Mini Pro dedicated autoreader. The color of the solution of the Pro-1 micro can be used for a qualitative reading only if the protein pen is removed when the program ends. If the protein pen is not removed as soon as the result is informed, the color of the solution will continue to evolve. For this reason, an audible alarm will be set off 30 seconds before the reading ends to warn the operator that the incubation time is close to being completed. You can turn off the alarm by pressing the alarm button. When the incubation is completed, the autoreader will print the results and display a red or green light. Green light means the amount of residual protein swabbed is below the threshold set. Red light indicates the amount of residual protein swabbed is above the threshold set. Further details will be shown in the print ticket. Keep in mind that you can use our exclusive BioNova Cloud traceability software to track, save, and manage all your readout processes. The example swabbing shown in this video was done following HTM 01-01 guidelines, but we have also developed a mobile app called SurfaceEye designed to comply with required ISO standards. Both modes are connected and integrated with BioNova Cloud. You can check the links in the description below to know more about BioNova Cloud and SurfaceEye.